The tears of butthurt have never tasted so good. Bro. Oh, man. I am enjoying every second of this. The Snyder Cut is coming, and the bloggers, the purple-haired feminists, the man babies are all crying. Hector Navarro is probably sleeping under his bed, holding a Captain America pillow, wishing and praying that the Snyder Cut doesn't come out. Because we all know Hector Navarro is a little soy boy who probably watched Captain Marvel 100 times in theaters. But yeah, and we all know the media is going to try to crash and burn this movie. The media is going to do everything in their power to make sure that this movie is not a hit. So you're going to see all the hit pieces. Zack Snyder is terrible. Warner Brothers is misogynist company. Zack Snyder doesn't know anything about DC movies. Zack Snyder ruined everything. The DC universe was on the right track, and now it's going to get derailed by the Snyder Cut. Trust me, you're going to see all this nonsense, all the hit pieces, and guess what? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. They lost. The media lost. The bloggers lost. The fans won. We won. We're getting a Snyderverse. We're getting the Snyder Cut. We're getting Henry Cavill back as Superman. We're possibly getting Ben Affleck back as Batman. We're getting everything that we want as fans. Sorry, Birds of Prey 2, but that's not happening because we don't want that shit. All the bloggers and the soy boys, they want a Birds of Prey 2. The DC fans, we don't want that shit at all. We want Man of Steel 2. We want Ben Affleck going against Deathstroke in the HBO Max series, and we're possibly going to get all that. And the purple-haired feminists, that they're all crying, that they're all alone in their apartment with their 37 cats, can't get no man because nobody wants them. They're all bitter and sad. So what do they have to do? They have to turn all their hatred into Zack Snyder. You know, a director who's not going to bow down to SJW nonsense. Who doesn't bow down to all the nonsense that's going on right now. He's just a guy making films. And all the little soy boys, he's like, I don't like Zack Snyder because he just makes dude bro movies. Bro, shut the hell up. Shut the hell up. Go grab your fucking Captain Marvel DVD and go watch it and cry and masturbate to it, you fucking weirdo. Nobody wants that shit, okay? So all the butthurt, all the rage, all those little weirdo purple-haired feminists who are outside right now crying, screaming in the air because Zack Snyder ruined their life. They all lost. And we're all going to be sitting down in 2021, clicking on HBO Max, and watching Zack Snyder's vision for Justice League. Oh, it's going to be so epic. It's going to be so epic, bro. we're gonna enjoy it. And we're going to click on Twitter and laugh at all the people who hate it. Like, this sucks. I prefer Joss Whedon's better, okay? Joss Whedon did it better. I can't take this. All this male testosterone is too much for me. Zack Snyder, you ruined everything. Oh, it's going to be hilarious. It's going to be hilarious. This is too dark for me. This is too dark. Why can't it be like Marvel and Thor Ragnarok? Because Marvel's trash, bro. We don't want that kiddie shit, bro. We don't want that Teletubby Marvel fluff. This is DC, baby. This is DC. Things get fucking hardcore in DC, bro. Things get dark. Things get serious. We run this shit, bro. This is DC's time. And we're taking over. All right? Marvel's done. DC's taking over this bitch. And we're just gonna fucking toss off all those little fanboys crying, bitching and moaning. We're all gonna give you wedgies, bro. This is toxic masculinity DC, and I'm here for it, baby. Let's go. And Zack Snyder is doing what we're all doing right now, laughing, pointing at the losers, pointing at those fanboys, pointing at those purple hair feminists, just laughing at them because we won. We won and you lost, bitch. DC's Zack Snyder's Justice League is coming and we're all excited. And let's do this shit. We won.